Anne Hathaway is a white savior, and I've got some pretty unpopular opinions on it coming up today on The Hollywood Conservative for The Rebel. Anne Hathaway, the actress, blew up on Twitter yesterday for remarks she made on an Instagram post. Now, I'll give you her remarks, but that's not really the meat of my video today. I'll tell you what she said, and then I will give you some Twitter reactions. And then I want to get on my soapbox for a hot minute and tell you exactly what I think, which is probably going to get me in trouble, but whatever. Her Instagram post was in reference to a black teen who was murdered in Oakland by a white man, and she wrote this. "White people, including me, including you, must take into the marrow of our privileged bones the truth that all black people fear for their lives daily in America." All right, first of all, the POC I know are growing quite weary of the whole white savior thing. My best friend doesn't live in fear, and he's black. In fact, I don't know a single black person who lives in fear for their lives on a daily basis. Maybe if they live in Chicago, maybe if they live in Baltimore or East LA. Secondly, I bet I can name one group who is even more fearful: Trump supporters in LA. I can't have a Trump sticker on my car because I know that my windows will get bashed in and my car will get keyed. I can't wear a MAGA hat out in public unless I'm with some friends who can help me out in a crisis, because as we saw last week, when my pal Joy Villa and some other Trump supporters went to Donald Trump's star on the boulevard, there's a pretty decent likelihood that you're gonna get jumped. Now, just to solidify my first point even further, here are some Twitter reactions from black people. Brian Bledsoe tweeted this: "I didn't know Anne Hathaway was black because I thought white people's opinion on the black community are invalid, or I guess that's only when those opinions are convenient." Yep, nailed it. Only when the opinion complements their narrative. Wayne Dupree tweeted this: "Does Anne Hathaway really think all the black actors and actresses really fear for their lives every day? How out of touch is she, or is she just pandering to get her 15 minutes of 'I know how you feel' bullcrap?" And Kira Davis tweeted this: "What the heck does Anne Hathaway think I do every day? Does she picture me weeping and shaking before I leave the house every morning? My God, the stench of white savior complex is overwhelming. Hey Anne, I have news for you. Black people can have normal lives too." Again, all tweets from black people. Also happen to be independent thinking and conservative leaning people. Now, obviously, the fact that this young girl was murdered is absolutely awful, but let's not distort the situation. More than twice as many white people are murdered by black people than black people murdered by white people, as in 500 to 229. Those are FBI crime stats. So forgive me for not feeling too terribly sympathetic to your one-sided outrage, and here's where I'm really going to get some heat. So let's go. You keep looking for a white savior, but he has already come, and I'm not talking about Jesus Christ, because anthropologically speaking, he wasn't white. Your white savior was Abraham Lincoln, founder of the Republican Party. His ideals are what you should be adhering to and emulating, but you have allowed yourselves to be bought out and disenfranchised and misappropriated by the Democrat Party. You sold your morals and your ideals for false promises by the Great Society and LBJ, and allowed the left to hijack your story. After the abolition of slavery, you permitted yourselves to be put back in bondage by the same people who put you there in the first place, Democrats. But you don't even realize it, because it's now bondage of thought instead of shackles and chains. The real racism here is the notion that black people need white people to stand up for them. Don't you think you're powerful enough? Don't you think you have the knowledge and inspiration and voice to do your own hard work? Because I certainly believe that you don't need Democrats or some Anglo Becky with the good hair to fight your battles for you. I happen to think that as human beings, regardless of skin color, you have the power within yourself to improve your situation by thinking for yourself and acting accordingly. Thanks for watching, everybody. I'm Amanda Head, the Hollywood Conservative for The Rebel. If you enjoyed my commentary and want to hear more from all of us here at The Rebel, subscribe to our premium content at www.therebel.media/shows. Make sure you're following us on Facebook and Twitter for all of our latest news, and download our new app for The Rebel Media on the App Store. That way you will have instant and easy access to all of our latest videos and your favorite Rebel shows. Thanks so much for watching. I'm Amanda Head for The Rebel.